Alright, what's up, everyone? Pathfinder here, and today we're gonna be discussing on what Killing Floor 2 actually needs, content-wise. Okay, now look, I'm going to make this disclaimer right now. This video is not about complaining, not about being negative or disrespectful to the developers. Its main purpose is to share, you know, some of my opinions, or should I say ideas, on what the future of Killing Floor 2, you know, should be like. Hopefully. So yeah, I got 10 different ideas for the game, or just like overall improvements. But yeah, this video, it's pretty much just like my opinion on the overall state of the game. And since it's gonna be my opinion, you can either agree, disagree, but if you do disagree, then be sure to leave in the comments, you know, why. Oh, and by the way, if you guys have any of your own ideas, then be sure to leave those ideas in the comments. Just before I start, I do realize that, you know, Tripwire has a tight budget for Killing Floor, so like I said, every single one of these ideas probably not gonna come true, but if they do, I'm gonna be a very happy camper. So yeah, let's start with the first thing that I have in mind, and those are weapons. So yeah, you might be saying, put Funder, why weapons? Tripwire, do weapons, yes? I mean, this is kind of like a controversial topic for the game, because, you know, Tripwire do actually do a very good job on weapons, you know, providing them for each perk, you know, make that perk more interesting. But recently, I mean, you can kind of see from the Halloween update, they made reskins, and they made $10 per a weapon. And in my opinion, weapons are a huge part of the update, and making them behind a paywall, yeah, it's gonna hurt the game in the long run. But yeah, overall, I do appreciate that Tripwire are still doing new weapons, but I do not appreciate the fact that one weapon is 10 bucks. I mean, you can argue that, you know, you get skins alongside with that new weapon you buy. But I mean, if I'm being honest here, I could care less about those skins. So yeah, I'm just gonna make the statement, Tripwire, please do 4 weapons for 10 bucks. That's pretty understandable. And don't make them reskins, for the love of God. Anyways, Killing Floor 2 is kind of like known for its weapons because they just look so smooth. You know, slow motion looks so smooth, everything is just so freaking perfect. But I mean, my god, don't ruin the game by making $10 per one weapon, come on. So yeah, that's all I gotta say about weapons, keep doing weapons, just don't make, you know, one weapon worth 10 bucks, cause that's just saying, basically, fuck you. So yeah, that's all I gotta say about weapons, and now let's move on to bosses and Zeds. So yeah, now you might be saying, Pathfinder bosses and Zeds, they take a lot of money to implement and, you know, balance, you know, make them fit. Fair enough, the last time Tripwire made quote-unquote new Zeds were the Edars. And Edars, fair enough, I do like their design, I just don't appreciate the fact that, you know, they're robots, because, you know, Killing Floor should be about flesh and gore, and, you know, robots just don't fit in. What else can I say? I mean, if the Edars were, like, actual, I know, husk variants, I would be completely fine. But I mean, we have them, they're not going to delete them, and they're probably not going to make them any different anytime soon. So yeah, what is this topic all about? Well, pretty much, Killing Floor is a horde shooter game. And how do you make a game like that a bit more interesting? You add more enemy types. I mean, fair enough, Tripwire are making a new boss called the Matriarch, so that's gonna be a step in the right direction, as long as it's gonna be, like, a unique boss. Cause I mean, if the boss is just gonna be another freaking reskin, yeah, it's gonna be pretty bad. As long as Tripwire make new Zeds, new unique Zeds that aren't just like reskins or just a copy of another Zed, then that's gonna be very freaking good for Killing Floor. But if they just keep on doing, oh, this is a Claude, but it has 4 arms, hey, new Zed, have him. I mean, that's not exactly, you know, original, now is it? Recently, I've been seeing a lack of originality from Tripwire to Killing Floor 2, but that could be down to them, you know, not having enough money to, you know, make their dreams come true for the game. But I mean, I'm no financial expert, so I don't even know what the hell's going on behind the scenes. But all I do know is that, you know, Killing Floor has DLC, has microtransactions. Fair enough, not the biggest community out there, but still a fair amount of people still playing the game, despite their, you know, bullshit stuff they added. Welp, I'm getting off track, back to the topic of Zeds and bosses. Yeah, this game needs a bit more of that. And if all possible, more frequently. And now we're gonna be moving on to the next topic, that is weekly outbreaks. Man, it's been like 3 years with the same weekly outbreaks. They get boring and people just forget about them. So what's an easy fix for this? Make new ones. You ain't lacking any sort of, you know, skins or cosmetics to add for the wards. And on top of that, if you don't know what to put to weekly outbreaks, just take a look at the workshop. Because on the workshop, there's a mod called the Fiesta Game Mode, and that pretty much has content for weekly outbreaks. Weekly outbreaks, when they first came out like 3 years ago for that, you know, summer update. Dude, I was so hyped each week, because, you know, you had something new to play, you had something new to try out. A new skin to unlock, new cosmetic. And you know, a lot of people came back because, you know, they finished the weekly outbreak and then the next week a new one came out, so everyone wanted that reward and tried it out. So yeah, weekly outbreaks were a very magnificent idea, but they just left it. Not sure why, but they did. In my opinion, Killing Floor 2's main problem is, you know, the lack of replayability, because the only thing you play Killing Floor for, there's like multiple reasons, I'm just saying mine, that's to like level up your perks. And once you level up those perks, yeah, there's just nothing in the game to keep you going. And that's why a lot of people just come back for, you know, updates. They play like maybe a week or maybe less of that update and then they just quit. My main point is there's nothing in between updates for you to actually play the game for. So yeah, that's why I do believe weekly outbreaks were the best idea they've ever had for the game. Then they left it. So yeah, this is what I had to say about weekly outbreaks. Please, just add new ones. Come on. And since we're talking about rewards and weekly outbreaks, let's go and talk about the seasonal objectives. Yeah, boy. Okay, hear me out on this one. Killing Floor 2 has 4 updates. You know, spring, summer, fall, and Christmas. Now, all of those updates are themed, and with those updates, you also get seasonal objectives to complete. Now, the main problem with seasonal objectives is that they are piss easy to complete. I mean, what the hell? I mean, seasonal objectives should be, you know, at least to add playtime to the game, you know, to keep players wanting to play the game, to unlock that special reward. But I mean, since, you know, seasonal objectives are so piss easy to complete, the reward is also pretty garbage. And that's, you know, another point I'm gonna make in just a couple of seconds here. But yeah, seasonal objectives, like I said, main problem of Killing Floor is the lack of replayability. So when each update comes out, make seasonal objectives more harder to complete. They don't necessarily have to be, you know, grinding, but they could be something at least a little bit challenging, like, let's say, 25 headshots without missing a single head, or let's say, I don't know, throw a medic grenade and heal 2 people while also killing Zeds. Or you can even do something cool with, you know, the new weapons you're gonna be adding, you know, the free ones at least, because there's gonna be, you know, DLC weapons every single time now. But yeah, with the new free weapons, do a certain amount of headshots, or, you know, kill a fleshbound or a boss with it, or just like something that isn't just, oh, kill boss, easy, or kill 1000 Zeds, or complete weekly on new map, and complete the new map, yes, very hard. But yeah, bottom line, these, you know, recent seasonal objectives were piss easy to complete. If you had like 2 hours to spare, you could do them in 2 hours. Like, how's that seasonal? But there's gonna be that one guy saying, oh, Pathfinder, I don't have that much time as you to play this game because I don't know, I have to do this and that and shit. I mean, the rewards should be for people who are like dedicated to the game. And if, you know, new people come in and they don't like the game, they're probably not gonna be interested in completing seasonal objectives anyway. But yeah, such as myself, I played this game for 2,500 hours now or something stupid like that. And recently, I've kind of been feeling like this game is pretty average friendly. They don't really care about, you know, players who play this game for a very long time. You know, if they did, they would add seasonals for beginners and seasonal objectives for, you know, the longer playing players. I don't know, just something different. Because if you're like a new player, yeah, some of these seasonal objectives could be a little bit hard for you to complete, you know, such as like, I don't know, endless. And if you have like, I don't know, 10 hours, yeah, you probably aren't gonna be completing that objective. But I mean, that's what this game is all about. You have to keep on playing to get better at the game. Right? Isn't that every freaking game? But yeah, make seasonal objectives a little bit longer and a little bit harder. And now let's move on to the rewards. Yeah, boy. I mean, I already said that in the previous point that I made, but yeah, the rewards nowadays are just weapon skins. They're not even, you know, outfits or, you know, a weapon. So yeah, make better seasonal rewards, like outfits or just a whole new weapon that you can unlock before everyone else. So yeah, that's all I had to say about the rewards, and now let's move on to something that Killing Floor should probably consider, and that is a quote-unquote battle pass.
Boy.
Yeah, I know, Pathfinder, Fortnite, blah blah blah, but hear me out. Like I said, Killing Floor lacks replayability, so a battle pass would make freaking sense, especially for a game like this. I mean, fair enough, Killing Floor was not firstly known for all of the cosmetics and shit like that, if you look at Killing Floor 1, but I mean, Killing Floor 2 obviously has that approach. I mean, they need to make money somehow. You know, they make money through cosmetics and DLC, so why not just make, I don't know, a free battle pass for the free players and a paid, you know, premium battle pass for, I'd know, 10 bucks. And you guys probably already know how the hell the battle pass works. The more you play, the more items you unlock. And if you're a free player, you're gonna get some of those items, but if you're a premium player, you get, I'd know, double XP, you get more cosmetics, more weapon skins, you know, premium looking skins, because, you know, Tripwire do add a lot of freaking skins to the game. And, you know, the quote-unquote battle pass would also add a ton of replayability to the game, because, you know, when you're actually playing and killing Zeds, yeah, you're gonna get points for a tier up in that battle pass, so that's gonna keep you going, so you can unlock more stuff. I mean, isn't that just, like, logical? I mean, for me it is, cause that would be pretty freaking cool. So yeah, you would actually get rewarded for playing Killing Floor, because once you level up all the perks to 25, yeah, that's it. I mean, you can say that, you know, the Dosh Vault is a thing, but I mean, let's face it, the Dosh Vault is actually pretty poorly designed. And that is my other point, the Dosh Vault. Okay, so when the Dosh Vault was first introduced, I thought it was gonna be cool. I mean, it was, for like 5 days, but then it just got stale, because when you actually reach that bar to get, you know, a Dosh Vault crate, you get something at random. I mean, at least you get to, like, open something and shit like that, but my god, it's just poorly designed, man. So yeah, the Dosh Vault, in my opinion, should have, like, an overhaul. It shouldn't be just like, oh, you're stacking up money, and that's it. So yeah, this is how I would personally change the Dosh Vault, and once you actually click the vault icon, you get greeted by an in-game store, just with, you know, vault items. And, you know, with the money you racked up, you get to spend that money on items you actually want, instead of, you know, just getting pajamas 3 times in a row and then just recycling them and get pajamas again. You actually get to click and buy what you want. But yeah, I'm not quite sure why Tripwire are obsessed with this RNG system, but they are, sadly. But yeah, in my opinion, again, when you click the vault icon, you get greeted by, you know, your Dosh Vault, your stacks. But on the side, you get, I know, like a scroll bar with, you know, all the items the Dosh Vault has. And then you just click, purchase, and then, you know, the vault money goes gradually down. Because right now, yeah, you're just stacking up money and that's it. Pretty pointless. But yeah, my main problem with the Dosh Vault is the RNG system. It's pretty poor. Well, the next meme, or should I say next idea, and that's gonna be about the upgrade system.
Yeah, boy.
We can all agree that the weapon upgrade system is pretty freaking boring. I mean, the only thing it does is, oh, increase a little bit of damage on your weapon. And I mean, it works. It does increase the damage, and that makes, you know, that weapon you upgrade a little bit more viable at later waves. So, you know, you don't have to always rely on the top tier weapons to do the job. So yeah, the upgrade system, in my opinion, when I first heard about it, I thought it was gonna be, oh, you add this attachment on your weapon, you can add extended magazines, you can, I'd know, reduce recoil, or increase the rate of fire yet get more recoil, or just something like that. But nope, they just went with the most simplistic path, and that is just increase a little bit of damage. Now, if you ask me, the upgrade system has a lot of potential in Killing Floor, but as it is currently, it kind of feels like a pointless feature. But I mean, Tripwire have been known to add a bunch of features that no one even likes, then they just keep them in the game and never return to them. Hint hint, versus mode. But yeah, in my opinion, they should, before adding a useless ass feature, they should ask the community if that's a good idea for the game. Because if a feature that they want to add they think is good, maybe us, the community, think it's gonna be pretty freaking pointless. And, you know, a little bit out of place. Now, how do you improve the upgrade system? I mean, if any of you ever played Zeturnal, yeah, that mod has a pretty freaking unique upgrade type of deal. You know, you can increase the damage, you can reduce recoil, and you can increase weapon shooting speed. You know, just like shit like that, but it costs money. So yeah, instead of just bumping up the damage, you can also do a lot more things to the gun, which is pretty logical. So yeah, that's all I had to say about the upgrade system. Currently, it's a pretty useless feature, but I mean, it works. And now let's move on to the next topic, and that is objective mode.
Yeah, boy.
Well then, why am I putting objective mode in the ideas list? Well, pretty much, yeah, they have objective mode already in the game. Is it good? Far from good. I mean, it is a step in the right direction, but I mean, if you have like a format, you know, for one map, why do you reuse it for every other map? So yeah, currently we have 5 objective mode maps, I do believe Nuked, Outpost, Steam Fortress, Zed Landing, and the Christmas map. And all of those objective maps feel the same. If you guys ever played objective mode in Killing Floor 1, yeah, every single map in that game felt unique. Fair enough, some objectives here and there were a little bit reused, but nothing too drastic. Because in my opinion, a successful objective mode map should be, you know, about having its own unique style. I mean, you can kind of just like compare Killing Floor 1 to Killing Floor 2, and that's gonna give you the answer you are looking for. So yeah, how do they actually improve objective mode for Killing Floor 2? Yeah, they just have to make unique objectives for each map, not the same ones. I mean, if they're gonna make, you know, story-driven type of objective mode maps, that's gonna be cool. But how these current ones are, yeah, they don't even add that much of a storyline. So yeah, that's all I gotta say about objective mode, and now let's go to the last idea I have, or shall I say improvement, and that is achievements.
Yeah, boy.
Now, you might be saying, Pathfinder, why the hell achievements? Why didn't you put, I don't know, perks, new maps? I mean, the answer to that is, most likely they're not gonna be making new perks at the rate Killing Floor is going right now, but if they do, yeah, that's gonna be pretty cool, but I highly doubt that. But with achievements, like I said multiple times, yeah, Killing Floor doesn't have that much replayability, or shall say doesn't have anything to add playtime to the game. And just making achievements for, I'd know, that one map they add every 4 months, 3 months, you know, that map and collectibles, yeah, you can complete that in, what, 5 matches? Or should I say 4 matches. But yeah, I do remember Killing Floor 1 achievements, and that's what I'm gonna be basing this comparison off of. Killing Floor 1 had some hard achievements, and you actually needed, you know, a team that was like willing to do those achievements for you, or you could just ask a bunch of friends. And that's something Killing Floor 2 just doesn't have, because most Killing Floor 2 achievements are for the map, level up the perk, and that's it. And you might be saying, oh, I'm a new player and 260 achievements is plenty. I mean, for a new player, it might be good because you have to like play everything eventually if you are interested in the game. But I mean, for people that have supported this game for a very long time, have been playing for a very long time, yeah, they just completed everything as it came out because, you know, you're actually passionate about the game and you just want to test everything, play everything. But I mean, once that update comes out, you just play for, I know, max a week, and then you don't have anything to play anymore. Well then, boys, these were my 10 ideas slash improvements slash what I want to see in game. If you guys agree or disagree, be sure to leave in the comments. And if you guys have any of your own ideas, then also leave in the comments. But yeah, the bottom line is, I still enjoy Killing Floor, it's my go-to game to play, and I just don't want to see it, you know, go down the freaking drain. But yeah, I still support Tripwire by, you know, getting some DLCs, you know, buying stuff occasionally, and on top of that, doing overall content for the game. So yeah, I still support Tripwire, because like I said, don't want this game to just go down the drain, because that's gonna be pretty bad, because there's gonna be, like, no games to play after this dies. At least in my opinion, because currently I really only enjoy Killing Floor, Rocket League, and Dead by Daylight. I mean, maybe Postal 4, because that's a new game. But yeah, sometimes I am gonna admit it does come across that I'm just, you know, complaining about the game. But in reality, me complaining is just saying, yeah, this game can do a lot better. But yeah, I'm still gonna be supporting and recording this game for as long as I can, or as long as, you know, they're gonna provide, you know, actual content so I can, you know, actually record something. So yeah, hopefully this video was enjoyable to watch, and if it was, then be sure to leave a like, subscribe, and like I said, leave some ideas in the comments. Adios.